Now, we'll go for today type of stresses in power screw. Types of stresses in power screw. Okay. Now, power screw is subjected to load W. Power screw is subjected to load W. That means here, first stress that we are going to consider is direct compression because of load W. ये जो आ रहा है, W load आ रहा है. Okay. Now how it is going to fail? Okay. So as we know, here is our screw SI. This is our screw. Now if it is subjected to W load, if it is subjected to W load, then because of the W load, it is going to fail here. यहां से वो टूट जाएगा because this is the weakest portion. This is the weakest portion. So it will fail here. So this is the diameter DC because this is the core diameter. क्योंकि ये जो है, this is outer diameter, this is inner diameter, and there is a mean diameter. So here there is a DC. So that's why we can say that here area under this compression is pi by 4 dc square. Pi by 4 dc square will be the area. If pi by 4 dc square will be the area, then we can write compression load means compressive stress. So failure under compression or compressive stress. Failure under compressive stress, that we can write sigma c, because generally sigma c is the notation for compressive stress, that is equal to load upon area. So which is equal to load is w divided by area is pi by 4 dc square. Got it? So if you want, you can, yes, you can write this. Likh sakte ho, likhna hai to likho, so that you can go further. So this is the first equation. So direct compressive load. Shall we proceed further? Rupesh Kasbe, so mic on hai. Okay, so here we'll go further. Second type of stress. In the second type of stress, this screw is subjected to twisting also. So twisting is possibility. Kyunki wahan pe hume torque bhi dena hai because of rotation of that screw jack, or because of lifting of the load, there is a torque, and because of the torque there is a torsional shear stress. So first equation is over. So let us go for second equation. So second equation is regarding torsional. So here we have our screw, and I will write here second equation. So second equation is because of torsional load, or we can say torsional stress. Okay, so when this particular screw is subjected to torque, अभी हमने लोड लिया था, हम यहाँ पे टॉर्क ले रहे हैं बिकॉज इट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू टॉर्क. ओके, इफ वी ट्राई टू रोटेट दिस, इसको गोल घुमाएंगे, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, हियर देयर विल बी फेल्योर. सो फेल्योर विल बी लाइक दिस, या ऐसा टूट जाएगा, इट विल फेल लाइक दिस. एंड इट इज जस्ट लाइक अ फेल्योर ऑफ शाफ्ट. शाफ्ट जैसा हम जनरली शाफ्ट का जो इक्वेशन लेते हैं, सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ फेल्योर इज देयर बिकॉज ऑफ ट्विस्टिंग, देयर इज अ फेल्योर. सो टॉर्शनल स्ट्रेस दैट बिकॉज ऑफ टॉर्क, सो टॉर्क, देयर इज अ टॉर्क टी. ओके, एंड टॉर्क टी इक्वल्स टू पाई बाय 16 डीसी क्यूब इंटू शियर स्ट्रेस. ये तो हमें पता है क्योंकि हमने शाफ्ट चैप्टर पढ़ा है. इन द शाफ्ट चैप्टर वी नो दैट इफ देर इज अ शाफ्ट विच इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ट्विस्टिंग, दैन टॉर्क इक्वल टू पाई बाय 16 डीसी क्यूब इंटू टाउ. टाउ इज द शियर स्ट्रेस. सो दिस इज द इक्वेशन. इन दिस इक्वेशन अगेन that particular shear stress is on DC. So this is the shear stress, torsional shear stress equation. So torque equal to pi by 16 DC cube into tau. Next thing is, if I combine that, because we have direct compression stress plus torsional shear stress, because here both type of stresses are combined on this DC. DC ke upar dono aa rahe. There is a direct compressive stress as well as torsional shear stress. So that's why we must go for our principal stress equation. So if there is a combined stress, then we must go for principal stress. So in the principal stress, we are going to see the equation, common equation. So principal stress equation can be like this, combined equation. So in the combined equation, we can go here, the principal stress sigma n, okay, 1 or 2 equals to whatever direct stress. Here we can consider direct compression. So DC divided by 2 plus under root DC divided by 2 square plus whatever shear stress square. Here we are having shear stress equation. So tau equal to tau divided by pi by 16 D cube. So this is principal stress equation for the compressive or tensile. Then again we are having maximum shear stress equation, maximum shear stress. So maximum shear stress is the this much part of this principal stress. So tau max equal to obviously under root whatever compressive stress and the shear stress. So this is the maximum principal stress equation which combines direct compressive stress and torsional stress which comes on our screw. Okay, jaisa ki humne dekha ki sirf simple torsion liya to ye equation aayega. If there is a direct stress, then w divided by pi by 4 dc square will be the equation if we combine that. So for the combined stress, here 1 or 2, that means here plus or minus will be there. If I consider only 1, then we must take plus. If I consider sigma n2 minimum, so generally we'll take maximum. Generally we'll take maximum. That's why generally we take maximum means 1. So here 1 if I take, then there is a plus. Okay. So that is the principal stress equation, combined stress equation. So this completes our third combination or third equation. Okay, there is a chances that because of the low W, direct shear stress of the screw is also possible. if there is a direct shear stress, then what will be the equation? Okay, so that we'll write here. So I think all of you have written this. So let us go further. The equation of direct shear stress in the screw. Okay, so now let us go further. Equation of direct stress. Okay, so if this is I think number fourth equation, direct shear stress on screw. Okay, direct shear stress on the screw thread. Okay, if I say direct shear stress on the screw, so obviously the screw is our square or trapezoid. Okay, so if there is a direct shear stress, mean what will happen? Because of direct shear stress, now there is a failure like this. So because of direct shear stress, this part of the thread will shear out. So this is the, you can see here, this is the thread part which is going to come down and which is going to fail like this. Now look at this, how it is going to fail. So there is a failure like this. A part of the thread, if come down and if it is going to fail because of the load acting, here there is a load acting because of the load W, part of the our thread come down, then this will happen. But there is no only single thread. So if there are n number of threads, n is number of thread in contact. Okay, so if there are n number of threads in contact, if there are number of threads in engage, kyunki nut mein jitna aayega utna ek failure ho sakega. So if there are n number of threads in contact, then we can say that area under shear failure A. Now how we can find that? So we know that this is DC. Okay, this is DC. So this is pi into DC. So there is a pi into DC. So this is here, thickness of one thread is T. So multiply by T. This is for one thread. If there are n number of thread, then we can say n. So pi into DC into T is the area under shear, multiply by n. So that is total area. Yes, Mangesh Dole. Mangesh Dole, kai vicharayche? Okay. So here, this is the area under shear. So the shear stress, whatever load upon area. So shear stress tau equal to load is W divided by area is pi DC T and N. So this is the equation that we can consider for the direct shear stress on the screw. So if you want, you can take this. So this is the equation for direct shear stress. Okay. Same thing may happen with nut also. This is on the screw, direct shear stress on the screw. So same thing can be happen with nut also. So we'll go for next equation. So that is the shear stress in the nut. Okay. Sudarshan Davule. Kai problem hai ka? Are you want to ask something? Okay. Now the next equation is direct shear stress in the nut. Okay. So let us go further. The fifth equation, the direct shear stress on nut. So I'll go for that. Now here, what will be the difference between these two? That will be clear here. I'll put here the fifth condition, the direct shear stress in the nut. Here instead of screw, if I say the direct shear stress in nut. Okay. So in nut also there are n number of threads in contact. But when we think about the nut, so the failure will be like this. So this is part of nut. The nut part remain as it is. Okay. So nut part remain as it is, and this is the outer diameter, because and a portion of thread is going to cut down like this. So here the nut portion will come with our screw. The nut portion will come with our screw. So this is the failure. A complete nut comes down. Then what will be the area under shear? So area under shear, now here it is D0. It is same as that one, D0. So area will be equal to pi D0 into, now here if there is a single thread which is going to cut, then T multiplied by N number of threads. Okay. So here for a single thread, T will be the thickness similar to our nut. If the portion in between two threads is going to cut, it is also same as T. So that means here the stress equal to again whatever load or force divided by area. So shear stress in the nut, that can be find like this, W divided by pi D0 T and N. Okay, pi D0 T is the area and N number of threads are in engage. So this is the one more equation that comes out when we consider direct shear stress in the nut. If I consider direct shear stress in the nut, this is the equation. Okay. There is a one more possibility that as this nut and screw, they are in engagement. They are in engagement. So there is a crushing. So on that screw surface, there is a crushing or there is a bearing pressure. So one more failure that can be possible here is the bearing pressure or crushing failure of our threads. So after this, the next equation that we'll take is the crushing failure of our screw and nut. Okay. So I'll write here. The next equation, the sixth equation, bearing pressure, because it is generally called bearing pressure or crushing stress in nut or crushing stress on screw, because we can show it very well So bearing pressure or crushing stress on the screw. So that can be possible here. Now how it can be shown? So I'll draw here that particular bearing pressure. Similar to here, we can show like this. So this is our complete one thread. So this is one thread. Now on this there is a load. There is a load W. Because of this load W, there is a crushing. So crushing area will be here. The crushing variable here for the one thread, the bearing pressure is on this surface. So there is a crushing of this surface. We know that this is core diameter DC and this is our outer diameter D0. Okay. So now we can say about the area again. Area under failure that we can write like this. So there are two circles. So pi by 4 D0 square, pi by 4 D0 square minus DC square, because here this is the area, pi by 4 D0 square minus pi by 4 DC square multiply by n, if there are n number of screw in engage. Now number of screws engaged, then we must multiply that with n. So that means here we can say bearing pressure PB is equal to load upon area. So that means here we can write like this: PB equals to W divided by pi by 4 D0 square minus DC square into number of threads in engage or number of threads in contact. So this is one more equation which gives the idea about how that particular screw is going to crush if there is a bearing pressure or crushing. So this is one more equation in our design of screw. Okay. So we'll complete our stresses in the screw by taking one more equation, but that equation is not asked in our exam. This is just for information, because in your strength of material, you may find one Johnson or Euler or Rankine formula, and based on that, there is a buckling or crippling of the screw. So the next failure, which is crippling of the screw. So final equation I will write. So I think all of you have taken this. So the seventh and last step is buckling of the screw. So what is meant by buckling? That also we'll draw here, and after that we'll write the equation. Okay, so this is the equation, which is bearing pressure or crushing stress on the screw. Final equation that here we'll write about the crippling of screw or buckling of the screw. Seventh equation. Buckling or crippling of screw. Okay, generally it is called buckling, so I'll write buckling of the screw. What is meant by buckling? So as we know, we are having that screw. The screw may buckle like this. The screw may buckle like this. So here nut remain as it is. And because of the load, because of the high load, that screw may buckle. So this is the threads. And so there is a buckling. So it is called buckling. And we have a number of condition in buckling. You might have already learned in your strength of material. There is a one end is fixed, another end is hinged, both end are hinged. Some such type of conditions are there in the column and strut chapter. Column and strut chapter you might have learned in strength of metal. So this crippling or buckling load, it is having one simple relationship. So as I told, nobody is going to ask this in our exam. Why? Because here this is extra equation. We must know that. Only for information, you can write this as equation of buckling. There are number of terms, new terms that will come here. So depend upon different theories. There is a Euler theory, there is a Rankine theory, there is a Johnson theory. So this is Johnson's equations. In this Johnson equation, here this is yield strength. Again, there is a one more term, C. So that 4C here, there is a C. So C is end condition. As I told, end condition, maybe one end is fixed, another end is free, one more both end hinge, such type of condition is there. So here C is generally 0.25 because one end is fixed and another end is free. So this condition is there, end condition. So C is equal to 0.25 default. Length of the screw, and K is radius of variation. So this is one more last equation. So this equation is not expected because this is buckling equation. As per our syllabus, we are having design of screw and nut. So screw and nut part that already studied. So just for additional information, you can say that there is a buckling of screw, and the buckling of screw is based, this is based on Johnson's equation. So there is variety of conditions, and depend upon the condition, there are number of scientists also. So Euler, Rankine, Johnson. So this is Johnson's condition. Okay, one end is fixed and another end is free. So that's why C is 0.25. So almost this complete different formulas and different equations based on the design of our screw. So tomorrow we'll take our numerical based on this, and simultaneously we'll take welded and our screwed joint also. Okay, so